Hey guys, and welcome back to the second episode of my fresh start. As you can see, oh, actually, I'm not at the base yet. as you're about to see, I've been raided overnight. In the last video, I said that I wasn't going to build in the same place as I raided this guy on a different server, but dumbass me decided to build in the same place, and this is what happened. He blew my door and left me a nice note that said, "You think you could just steal my PTs without revenge or something?" And there was his tribe name after that. So GG to that guy, I have no salt. He found my server fair and square, obviously, and managed to raid me. Luckily, all my stuff was in upload, so I didn't lose anything really important. He would have got some ingots and maybe like prim flak out of that, but yeah, I definitely didn't lose anything super important. So the plan today is to definitely do some PvP as usual, and also go over to Rag to get fur armor. I'm planning on building in the snow somewhere, I'm just not sure where yet. In fact, I'm definitely gonna move servers after seeing this guy has found it, but it'll be on another island server, I think. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I'll get back to you guys when we're doing something interesting. I imagine somebody wants to see, or maybe some of you want to see where my base was. So I'm gonna head over there right now. It's right here actually. Pull my map out. So this is the cords. There's actually two pillars here where you can build bases on as well, and it's hidden like deep in foliage. And if you put a base just down below where my base was, you're probably not going to get found very quickly. My base has been up for, well, this one's been up for one night and it got raided, so that doesn't really say much, does it? But I've had bases in there that have lasted probably 3 months without being hit, and then when they do get hit, it doesn't really matter because my stuff's an upload or skyboarded on an RG somewhere. So yeah, I just wanted to show that to you guys in case anyone wanted to build there. Alright guys, I just turned my recording on because I found a fat TP. I was just on the way to get some metal actually. Wow, that's a massive TP. It's all vault dropped, everything, you won't be quits of one on that. Yeah. That was interesting. I thought it was a base, that's why I turned my recorder on, but I could see the teleporter and it looks pretty cool, honestly. But yeah, I'm gonna head into the snow to where the rich metal nodes are and yeah, have a look over there. Okay guys, so I just arrived over here on a Ragnarok server and my dumbass forgot that Fern needed metal ingots. So currently I'm just looking for a raid that can give me a little bit of metal. I don't really want to have to farm it back on my home server. So yeah, I'm gonna try find a raid. If I can't find a raid, I guess I'll just get the pelt that I need for the fur, and then I'll head back to my home server and grind up some ingots, but hopefully I don't have to do that. So I'll get back to you guys if I find something, or killing sheep or whatever happens, I guess. So that was extremely unfortunate. The base was completely empty. Luckily I have an Arthur, so it didn't cost me anything and it only took me about 20 seconds to get in, but yeah, we're gonna have to go try find something else, hopefully with a little bit more profit. Looks like there's a stone base up there. I might just quickly check out if I could pick my Arthur. Hopefully this is not raided. Oh, it is. The demolish timer is so low. Oh, just got a hole in the door. Alright, we're gonna go see what else we can find. Alright, so I've been halfway around the map just looking for a base to raid that might have ingots, and I finally think I found something. 2x1, I mean, it's not super promising, but surely it'll have a couple of forges in there. So we're gonna break into this. Only downside to using an Arthur Blur is you gotta wait for your Crow signal. So, is there another base? Oh, that looks rather raided. Oh, no, it's not. Yeah, it is. Yes, it is. I'm blind. So yeah, I'm just gonna wait for the timer to come up and then I'm gonna break into space. While I'm waiting, actually, I just wanted to inform you guys that I do actually have a duo partner, but he doesn't play much because school is not quite finished for the year for him, because he's a year below me. So once that does, he probably will start playing again and will probably turn it into a duo series, but for the moment I'm still solo, and everything I do at the moment is pretty much solo as well. when he does get back on, obviously it'll turn into a duo series, but we're hoping to not have any more people on other than that. We're probably just going to keep it at that, in fact. So, duo will be the max, but probably still be solo for a little while yet. I just thought I should probably let you guys know that, in case any of you thought I was in a tribe or anything. So, yeah. Okay, so the cryo time is finally up, and I thought I'd just demonstrate the effectiveness of an Arthropleura early game on stone bases, especially. Especially when it's only like a 30 minute time, even less. See, that door's already down, and I lost no mats whatsoever. So I'm gonna cryo this up, actually, and then head on. I really hope they have ingots, otherwise, I'm probably gonna transfer servers and go for another raid. I cannot be bothered farming. Oh my god, I just got baited again. Alright, so, in all honesty, I should probably just stop being a lazy ass and go farm some ingots, but, I'm not really about farming, so we're gonna go head to a drop, transfer out, and try find another base to raid. So, I haven't actually left the server yet. I've got sidetracked with yet another stone base. Oh my god, and my Arthur is not close enough to hit it. Okay, so I'm gonna whistle this onto it. And, as usual, I'll cut back to when I get into the base and there's no more ingots. Oh my god, guys, we finally found some damn ingots. That was way too hard. I mean, they had a little bit of other stuff in here as well. And I'm about to die. Lucky I put a bag down. But, oh, that's more pelt. And a lot of silk. I'm gonna take all that. But yeah, that is pretty massive, because that took way too long for me to find ingots. Oh, that'll wither me. Oh my god. That's really good for me. Probably gonna raise that, to be honest. Wow. This raiding for ingots really just paid off. Okay. I am still on the same server, by the way, so I didn't even get to a drop before I found this in the redwood. So yeah, I'm gonna make me some fur armor and then probably take this whooping bag back home as soon as I can, because that's pretty huge for me. I found a bob. He's trying to hide from me. I'm gonna poke him and kill him anyway. Oh, jokes. I'm terrible poking on Najee. So I'm just gonna kill him. Oh, he didn't have anything. I killed him because I need a little bit more pelt. And I cannot find any sheep anywhere, so I thought he might have some at least. Is it a turkey? Damn turkey. If you guys didn't know, this turkey's like super OP. I tried to kill one when I was on a horse when I first started playing again a few days ago, and that wrecked my horse within about 3 seconds. So yeah, don't mess with those. Just flying around looking for a drop, and I found this base. It's very badly made. As you can see, the generator sticking through the roof there, so that it'd be an easy flame arrow. They have some decently high level birds and other tames. The only issue here for me is the Plan X. I mean, it's probably all doable with flame arrows, to be honest. If I get the turrets down, I can flame arrow the Plan X. It's pretty time consuming. I am quite tempted. I will have to craft C4 for that, and that's fine. I've got a fabricator and stuff up on a different server. So yeah, we probably will hit that eventually. Probably not in this episode, we're running out of time a little bit, so yeah, we'll see what happens. Alright guys, so I'm back on my home server now. I crafted up all my fur so I'm not absolutely freezing to death. I've flown across the other side of the map from my base. I'm looking for a Pilovia. Not to put by my base, because people just fly out with parasaurs straight away, but to actually put in the underwater cave. Usually I put like a little bed down in the underwater cave, and I spawn on that, and I have like a couple storage boxes down there, but usually that gets destroyed within probably a day or so, even if I make it out of stone, metal, whatever, because it's cave damage, it's 6 times. So I'm looking for a pillow here just to chuck down there. It might last a little bit longer, as long as no one brings a parasol down there, really. I really need to start getting into the underwater cave, or caves, because if I run both of them, I'll be increasing my chances greatly of getting flak BPs, and then I'll be able to run bases and, well, turret bases, and that sort of stuff. But, yeah, I'm glad I've got my fur armor crafted, and I'm considering taming a Quetzal so I could live on that. I've lived on a Quetzal before. I had a cryofridge, fabricator, smithy. Obviously you guys would have seen that if you'd seen the previous video. Oh no. I'm stupid. I didn't include any of that in the previous videos because I didn't want anybody to fire my Quetzal. Not that that would happen with the amount of views I get, but I could never be too cautious. So yeah, I lived on a Quetzal for a while, and I'm kind of tempted to do it again just because of the safety of it. I lasted way longer than I ever have on a ground base, so I might do that. But if you guys have any tips or things that I should be doing that I'm not, feel free to tell me. Like, any comment helps, and it helps get the video out there, it helps get me more views, or yeah, just more people seeing my video, and that really helps me out a lot. So yeah, feel free to comment, drop a like, just tell me what you're thinking, and yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm just gonna do a quick little metal run here and bring it back to my base, because there's not that much metal around my base, unfortunately. So that's pretty much it for now, and I'll get back to you guys when I'm doing something else interesting, or it might be the outro. Okay guys, so that pretty much wraps up today's episode. I had a decent look around the snow for a Pelovia, but I couldn't really find anything. And I've been scouting around the map a lot for bases with my Parasaur, but again, couldn't really find anything, so I'm going to have to go to a different server to look. Hopefully tomorrow I get into that metal base raid, which had the turrets and the generator sticking through the roof. It a terribly built base on Ragnarok. Bases like that generally don't last any more than a few days, but they've obviously been going a little while, so hopefully they're still up. I'll probably do a massive flame arrow grind in the next video, just show you guys how to do it. Although it's fairly straightforward, I still want to show the recording process. I'd like to apologize if this video is a little bit PvE, or maybe a little bit boring, I don't know. I kind of wanted to show sort of what I was up to with this video, and we got that wyvern egg, so yeah, I just included parts that I usually wouldn't, I guess, like the failed raids. So yeah, if you could drop a comment or whatever, tell me what you think of it, tell me if you want me to do anything else. And I do know I need to tame an Anki, but I'm kinda lazy, and it's kinda the thing I dread doing because I have to do it on berries. So I'll probably get like a level 5 when I find one, tame one. But yeah, like I said, if you want me to do anything, or you have any better ideas, just hit me up in the comments, and I'll be sure to have a look. So thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.